New watch in Mr. B's watch collection. Epic intro? Well, yeah, I guess. Epic intro. Let's go. Hi, hello and welcome my friends to the review of my Tag Heuer Carrera I just added to my collection. I rock this one since a couple of days now and I would like to share with you why I did purchase it, especially why I did purchase it Tag Heuer, what I like, what I dislike, how the watch itself is and so on. So I hope you have fun with this review. Let's go! Let's discuss the technical data and specification first. Diameter of the Carrera, of my Carrera, is 43 mm. There's also, of course, a caliber 16 with 41 mm available, but I think the 43 do work very well for my wrists. Height of the watch, 15.3 mm. This is also a little bit affected by the slightly doomed sapphire crystal. Sapphire crystal on the top and on the bottom. The top side has also a little anti-reflective coating, which works, from my point of view, good enough. It's all right. Lug width, 21 mm according to the specs, but I measured 21.6 and I'm also able to fit in the Hirsch performance strap, which has 22 mm. Tag Heuer uses normally the Wojoo 7750 or the Lidia SW500 as a movement. I think in my watch works still the 7750, 42 hours of power reserve. Case, 100 meter water resistance, which is also nice to have. The crown is not a screw down crown, as well the pushers, which makes it easier to operate the stop function of the chronograph. The original Carrera was released on the leather strap, but I'm happy that Tag Heuer offers nowadays also bracelet options, and I think this one is very well made. Brushed surfaces with polished highlights, and it's really comfortable as it's, from my point of view, pretty flat and very flexible. The clasp is sort of integrated, full milled, and you do have half and full links to adjust it. Unfortunately, they use pins instead of screws, but it's makeable, and overall, I really do like the bracelet. The case itself is full polished. Everything is full polished on the watch. The case, the bezel inlay, even the pushers. So this is how I like it. And I also like a lot the iconic design and shape of the case. Well, my 43 mm is a little bit blown up version of this case shape, but it still is recognizable and you can directly see that you have a Carrera in your hands, which I sort of like. Let's discuss what I sort of dislike about my Tag Heuer Carrera. The first thing is reading the regular time. And this never occurred to me before, but right now when I check the time, it's 5 seconds 40. Well, this is a racing chronograph. So the focus there, of course, is on the minutes and seconds, which it's supposed to be. But if you would like to read the regular time, it's a little bit more complicated. Not complicated, it's easy when you know it, but it's something in the brain would say, oh, okay, you see a 5 or you see a 10, and it's then 10:40 or 5:40 or whatever. So it's In terms of the racing chronograph thing, a pro, but in terms of reading a regular time, a negative aspect. One thing which I really didn't like was that I found, when I did do the macro shots, some dust on the subdial, on the 30-minute counter of the chronograph. So this is something I would not have expected. Yeah, a little bit can happen, but when I saw this amount, it's sort of like a bummer, because this is not supposed to be in this price range. So this is a negative. I cannot see this with a normal eye, but in the macro shots I could see it. Another thing I sort of dislike is the missing fine adjustment possibilities. On the other hand, the bracelet and the clasp itself is very flat, and the clasp is sort of integrated, so it wears comfortable, but if you really would like to fine adjust your watch or your bracelet, you definitely cannot do this with the current bracelet of the TAG Heuer Carrera. I'm a big fan of polished cases, and I really love my Breitling Avenger. The case of the Carrera is well full polish. I don't know why, but I see on my TAG Heuer fingerprints easier than I do on my Avenger. I don't know why this is, maybe due to the different shape. I don't know, but this is something which stood out to me a little bit more on the TAG Heuer Carrera than on my Breitling Avenger. The Vosjoux 7750 has sort of its own tradition with TAG Heuer, as they did use it the very first time in 1977. So my Carrera is actually historically correct, at least that's my excuse that I didn't go for the in-house movement version. And the 7750 itself is a very reliable and rock solid movement, as well as the SW500. From my point of view, it's not the nicest movement on the market, and also this variation isn't nice decorated. Of course, you find a Côte de Genève on the rotor, it's all right, but a crystal clear case back, from my point of view, is a nice to have, no must have. I would have preferred actually a nice engraved steel case back. Let's discuss the things I do like about my TAG Heuer Carrera. The first thing, of course, is the dial color, its design, the focus on the seconds and minutes instead of the regular time, which is sort of a good thing if you do talk about a racing chronograph. Also, I like how it feels and wears on the wrist. I've got the same feeling when I did purchase my Breitling Avenger. I threw it on, it was like hitting a home run. It belongs to there since a long time. It's just fun to wear, it feels very comfortable, and it's a beautiful watch. Another thing I like about the Carrera is, of course, its movement. I'm aware it's not the in-house movement, but if you have service cost and maintenance in mind, this is a safe bet to use. And as I use this as a daily beta or for everyday carry, I use all my watches as a daily beta for everyday carry, by the way. It's just a safer feeling, it will not break the bank to repair it, and this is why I sort of like also the movement. So what is the difference from my Calibre 610 version to the current one? It's not much. We do talk about the bezel inlay, which nowadays is made of ceramic. The hands, the hour and minute hand, are different. And the bracelet is a little bit more rougher looking, a little bit more tulier looking. I prefer, to be honest, my bracelet, but would have loved to have the current handset on my Carrera, because I just prefer the shape of those. So why did I purchase a Carrera? To be honest, there are several of reasons. One of them is the name itself, Carrera, which is based on the Carrera Panamericana, a pretty rough race in Mexico. And the one or the other of you might know that I lived for 2.5 years in Mexico. My wife is Mexican, so we've got family there. This is something which makes a connection to that, sort of. Second thing is, I'm a big Porsche fan, so if you see the background, well, this is a Carrera I could afford. It's a little bit sad, isn't it? And of course, I would like to accomplish the sort of big five, my big five at least, which is Rolex, Omega, Breitling, TAG Heuer, and Seiko. And now I did accomplish that. So stay tuned for my watch collection review, which comes end of this year. So these are the main reasons why I did purchase this particular watch. Conclusion, what do you expect, guys? I'm still in the honeymoon period with this piece, but I'm very sure that this one is a keeper and this one will stay for quite a long time in my collection. But more important is, what do you think about this watch? Do you think it fits me? Do you think it fits in my collection? I'm eager to learn about your opinion in the comment section below. My friends, I wish you a happy rest of the week, a good start into the week, and look forward to see you in the next one. Say goodbye and auf Wiedersehen, euer Konstantin. Ciao, guys.